polar bend the strings for every girl and boy. Wondrous lands of make-believe will fill your heart with joy. A castle leads the entranceway to seven lands and more. Step inside a storybook, imagine what's in store.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Magic Kingdom.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Diz Explorers Podcast, where each week we explore all the different avenues of the great Disney universe. So this week, we're going to start a series that we're going to try to put out for you called Touring the Parks, where each episode that we dedicate to this series, we are going to pick a specific U.S. park. We're going to cover all six of them, and how we would plan our day accordingly. I know we did something similar with kind of like drop you in a park, and that was kind of like a game, but this is going to be a more detailed touring plan of how each of us would tour the parks as we would normally go. So those of us with children, how we would, you know, do the day with our kids from beginning to end. And so I think it's going to be really interesting to hear everybody's different takes on it, and how many similarities and how many differences we have between all of us. So tonight, we almost have a full cast. Adrian is with us.
Hello.
And Jessica.
Hi, everybody.
And Milford.
Hello.
And we have Crystal.
Hey, you all.
And I'm RJ. So tonight we're going to kick it off with the Magic Kingdom in Walt Disney World Resort in Florida. So with that, we're gonna start off with our master travel planner Jedi, Adrian, because I know she's gonna knock it out of the park, and she's probably been prepared for this for a month. So take it away,
well,
Adrian.
You know, things have changed in the Magic Kingdom lately, so it's actually kind of changed up the way we tour or plan to tour, because the original rope drop show is no longer at the train station, is now actually in the park. So I actually have only ever watched the rope drop show one time, I think, because we usually do pre-park opening breakfasts on our Magic Kingdom day, because I like to be back. I like to do Cinderella's Royal Table for breakfast and then hit the parks after that. But for this today, I'm kind of changing it up a little bit, as if I've never seen the new welcome show. So I would arrive at Magic Kingdom probably sometime around 8:30, 8:45, assuming that my children and husband get up in time to get there, because it's always, that's the hardest part, is getting them up and out of the hotel and fed and I'm ready to go, because I have the kind of kids that if you don't feed them within 20 minutes of waking up, then they're just grumpy and it's just not worth it. But anyway, so assume that we get to the park between 8:30, 8:45. I'm hearing that you're allowed in the actual park around 8:45. Is that right?
I believe
so. A little earlier?
Probably a little earlier. You know, I haven't checked on that as of lately, but I would assume they're letting you in early and then they're queuing everybody up around the hub like they used to do in the old days.
Exactly. So this is kind of new because this is a non-tested touring plan, but that would kind of be my thing, because I like to see the new stuff. So I'd want to see the new welcome show and see how that goes. And then once everybody starts breaking up, past experience has shown me that most people head towards the right. They go either Tomorrowland or New Fantasyland, kind of straight towards the back. So I feel in the past, I have headed out to the left first. And we like to get Adventureland and Frontierland done, mainly because there's not a lot with little kids that we can do. I can't, like, they don't do Splash Mountain. They don't do Big Thunder Mountain Railroad. I would not put my children on Haunted Mansion to save my life, because I don't want to think about the bad dreams I would have to deal with later. But Magic Carpets of Aladdin, Jungle Cruise, maybe Pirates, get all of that kind of in and out of the way, and then have fast passes for New Fantasyland stuff, probably starting around 10:30, maybe 11 o'clock that morning. So we do fast passes almost every time for Peter Pan's Flight, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, and one side of Princess Fairytale Hall, depending on which princesses are there. For the trip I'm taking in a couple of weeks, I'm doing it with Elena of Avalor. Even though my daughter's not all that into that show, I don't care. I love her.
Yeah.
And I want to meet her. So, you know, and then so then we spend a lot of time in Fantasyland because we've got teacups, we've got Mickey's Philhar Magic, which I love. Small World. My daughter loves Small World, so we spend a lot of time there. And then we usually grab, I didn't say anything about breakfast, but so I'll go back to that. But if I don't get a fruit Nutella waffle from Sleepy Hollow at some point in my Magic Kingdom day, like it doesn't matter anything else that I've done. So we would probably stop there for breakfast. And for lunch, we tend to do Friar's Nook right there behind the castle because yep. I love their macaroni and cheese.
Mm-hmm.
And plus you can get like a big hot dog or something and the kids can split it and it's easy and fast.
And there's ice cream right next door.
Yes. What's that called? Storybook
Treats? Storybook Treats, I believe. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, there's ice cream right there. There's Winnie the Pooh, you know, all of that stuff. So we get all of New Fantasyland done and head into Tomorrowland, where my kids are completely obsessed with the Tomorrowland Speedway. So I hate it because my six-year-old insists on driving, so I'm getting banged from side to side the whole time we're riding it. But you know, you do what you got to do for your kids.
Yep.
And then sometime around 3 o'clock, we'll break and go watch the Festival of Fantasy parade because I love that parade. It's my favorite parade of any that I've ever seen. I think the floats are amazing. Maleficent as the dragon is probably one of my favorite things to photograph and watch. All of the floats, I think, are just absolutely better than anything that I've seen in a really long time. I at least always stop at 3. Me and Melanie, my six-year-old, typically go see that. My husband couldn't care less. So he and Zachary, my three-year-old, tend to go off and do something else. But, and then we meet back up because usually they go do like Monsters Inc. Laugh Floor or something that's right there while we're watching the Festival of Fantasy. And then for the rest of the day, we just kind of go and see what we haven't done. Last time we were there, Barnstormer was a big hit. So we rode it probably 7 or 8 times. you know, you head back when you have little kids, you head back into Fantasyland because that's where all the stuff is.
Yep.
So, you know, and they're not going to do Space Mountain or any of the bigger kid stuff. Or we might grab some meet some characters. Buzz is over there in Tomorrowland. You know, or head over and try to find Jessie and Woody. Are they both still together in Frontierland?
They used to be over on the bridge coming across Splash Mountain, but I'm not sure. Yeah, and they were together last time I saw them, but honestly, it's been a few years since we've met them, so I'm not entirely sure where they meet now.
Yeah, I can't remember off the top of my head. But yeah, just kind of redoing things that we love or that we didn't get a chance to do earlier in the day. I have been a big proponent of the FastPass Plus system because now you can, you know, after you've used your first 3, you can keep going. So it's whatever we can grab a FastPass for. And because I kind of have a competition with myself to see how many FastPasses I can get in a day now. So that's something too that kind of helps to plan out our day. Where can we go next? What can we get the next fast pass for? Dinner? I don't know. We've ended up, as horrible as this is, we've ended up at, oh gosh, what's it called in Tomorrowland?
Cosmic Rays?
Yes. We end up in there a lot because you can get an 8-piece chicken nugget meal with fries.
Yes,
and
you
I can.
And I can
split it between my kids.
Yeah, hey, why not?
For fairly cheap. Plus it's indoors and there's almost always good seating. And when you're tired at the end of the day, that's kind of important. And then I make them hang around for fireworks, whether they want to or not.
There you go.
Oh, and of course I have to put in a plug for the Tomorrowland Transit Authority People Mover, cause it's my favorite thing. So we'll probably ride that 7 or 8 times depending on how tired we are.
Absolutely. That's
a bit of a, yeah, I was gonna say that's a bit of a hyperbole, not 7 or 8 times, but last time it was like 3 Because when you get tired and there's a short line, like, you just get on, sit, cool down a little bit. It's nice.
Absolutely.
But of course, you have to end with the fireworks. With my kids, I won't make them stay as late as the kiss goodnight. That was something just my husband and I did, but head out probably right after the fireworks. I'm really excited to see the new castle projection show. So that's definitely high on my list, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. So we go in a counterclockwise direction.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's generally how we would start, too, but. Cool. I like that. I don't see much wrong with that. Yeah, it's. I don't want to say it's easier when the kids aren't tall enough for all the mountains, but it does.
Yeah. It cuts down on line times.
It cuts down on line times, and you can get more accomplished in a day because you don't have to worry. Because that's four. There's four mountains in that park now.
There are four mountains?
Well, if you count Seven Dwarfs, Space, Splash, Big Thunder, and the Mine Train. I guess that's not a mountain, but it's a roller coaster. So there's four big e-ticket, rides that you don't have to worry about until they're 48 inches, which is fantastic.
Well,
so.
I think it's 38.
Well, 38
for Seven Dwarfs.
It is, yes.
Yeah, because Zachary can ride that one.
Yeah, that one is 38.
And loves it.
And the Barnstormer's 35, so.
Yeah.
But other than that, you don't have to worry about the three big ones. For a while.
Yeah, and it really does. And that's why I keep saying we can repeat things as long as it's not like Peter Pan's Flight, because I'm not waiting 90 minutes for that thing.
No, that,
But, we fast pass that thing and get it out of the way because my kids love it. But
absolutely.
It's not a, that's probably a nostalgia thing for you, right? That's an old one, but it's not my favorite.
It's not a must do for me. The kids enjoy it, I think. I don't know. I mean, we're going in a... the kids haven't been in 2 years now, so we'll see what they're going to gravitate towards. I mean, they were kind of involved in the planning and the fast passing and stuff like that, because, I'm to the point, like we've said on here, it's whatever they want to do, I'm fine with now. I've kind of learned to let the reins go and not be the, oh, we're doing this, we have to do this, I want to do this, so this is what we're doing. It's just, I kind of, now that they're 10 and 12... Let them do what they're going to do, So, but I'll get to that when we get to my thing. All right, cool. I like that. That's an easy plan to follow. I mean, there's nothing crazy about it. You're not bouncing all over the place. It's pretty strategic, which I would expect from you. Yeah, streamlined. Yeah. It's the complete opposite of how I go about it. All right. So next, I think we'll go with Crystal. We'll see what do you have?
The pro, right?
Yeah, the local. Crystals are local.
The local. Well, I did kind of approach it like a local would. So we have a 3-year-old, so we typically take him to the parks on the weekend. So we're still with the stroller, the whole deal. So what we normally do when we go to Magic Kingdom is we'll schedule breakfast at one of the monorail resorts. So usually we try to get like Kona Cafe around 9 o'clock. And we will go to the Polynesian, have breakfast, and park our car there, and then hop on the monorail and take the monorail over to the park, and then enter the park usually around, 9:30, 10 o'clock, depending on what time our reservation is. And because we're locals, if it's crazy, we just live and die by a fast pass. So we'll get in, we'll book our 3 fast passes for the day, and if it's busy, then we kind of just bob around the park all day, and we'll hop on rides that have short lines, seeing that we know, like, hey, we're going to be able to come back. So that is one of the advantages, is we won't wait in a really long line with a toddler. We'll just say, hey, forget it. Next time we'll try to get a fast pass if he really wants to go. So most of our time is really spent enjoying Main Street. So typically we come in, we'll ride the Main Street vehicles, and we pretty much have to do all of them. We have a 3-year-old boy who wants to get on the fire truck, to ride the trolley car with the horse. So we'll kind of go down and back the castle, back to the front of the park multiple times on multiple vehicles, and he'll sit and ring the bell and do the whole thing. So we'll spend probably 45 minutes to an hour just doing that. And we love it. Like, Main Street is my favorite place to be. So we'll just look at the Main Street windows. We'll sit and listen to the Dapper Dans. We'll hit up Starbucks and get another cup of coffee, and really just spend probably the first part of the afternoon mainly on Main Street. So really taking it all in, rather than running into the park, getting to the first ride or the first mountain like some people do. We kind of just take our time and take in all that Disney has to offer. And then normally we end up some part of our day at the baby care center just because we take our son in there, get some water and relax and kind of decompress for a few minutes. I don't know if you guys have ever used baby care center, but
yeah,
it's at the end of Main Street near like the nurse's center too. And they have high chairs, nursing rooms, and just TV, books, different things that you can go in there, change diapers, whatever. But we like just to go in there and let our son sit and watch TV and cool off because it is air conditioned. So that's a good secret spot to hang out for a bit. But we also try to plan on one reservation per day, and normally we end up at the plaza. So we love to go into the plaza. It's about the same price as a quick service meal. Mm-hmm. You get sandwiches, burgers, milkshakes, and we'll go in there and sit and use Tables in Wonderland or our annual pass holder discount, and we can sit down, get a table, see the castle, and it's as much as going to quick service. So that's kind of a hidden gem that we like to book a reservation, and you can usually get in there the same day. So being locals, we don't do a good job of booking reservations ahead of time. So that is one thing that we don't do well. So after about, you know, we get out of the plaza, it's around noontime. So really we kind of head over into the Adventureland and we'll swing through that area and hit, you know, Jungle Cruise. We typically try to get a Jungle Cruise, Tomorrowland Speedway, and Dumbo Fast Pass. Those are our three mainstays when we come into the parks, because those typically have a longer line. So we'll hit Magic Carpets. Usually we'll do the Aladdin Jasmine meet and greet too. And our son, unfortunately, loves the Peter Pan queue. And he, for like a toddler, loves to stand in line for that queue. So my husband will actually like brave it and go in there and spend, you know, 40 to 50 minutes, if not more, standing in that line. And our son is like so well behaved, has the best time ever. So that is one line that we do wait in pretty frequently. So we'll kind of swing through that area and really we'll head back to the center of the wheel and head back onto Main Street and hit up the Vamos Main Street Parade and typically even watch the castle show too. Kind of just hang out again on Main Street, and then we venture back into Fantasyland and we'll hit up, you know, Barnstormer. Our son is just tall enough to ride that one. So we'll do Barnstormer, usually hit our Dumbo Fast Pass, and our son loves to play in that Dumbo open area. That's like, sometimes we go in there and he'll spend an hour and a half, 2 hours just playing in there, making friends, having a great time.
Wow.
And we almost have to drag him out sometimes. And for us, it's air conditioned. So we're like, this is great. We'll stay in here as long as you want.
They should set up a bar in there. They'd make a killing.
Really? Well, and for us too, I mean, I don't want to make it sound like we're lazy parents or anything, but we're like, dude, he's having the best time and we get to sit here. This is awesome.
Yep.
So he'll just run around in there for a while.
That's like peak parenting right there. That's what I look forward to all the time. They're happy and I get to sit. We're good.
Yep. So typically when we walk out of Dumbo, we usually jump on the train and take that back to the front of the park. Sometimes we'll head over to the carousel. It really just depends on how lines are. If the lines are terrible, like, we'll just turn and leave. Like, we're like, all right, we're just going to go to a resort and like hang out at Animal Kingdom Lodge and we'll go play on their playground and have a beer and hang out. So if there are too many people, typically like a weekend, we won't really stick around. We'll wait till the crowds are a little lighter on non-peak times. So I guess, again, the locals' approach to hitting the park. But when we get back up to the front of the park, we're usually around 3 o'clock parade, and we're either praying for a nap or we're grabbing ice cream. And then we head over to see Mr. Jim play the piano over by Casey's Corner. So that is one of our favorite things to do, is sit and watch Mr. Jim play. And he'll actually interact with our son and let him push the keys on the piano. And he remembers our son. So that's how often we go. He remembers Stafford. So pretty cool stuff there. And then we usually grab a hot dog from Casey's Corner and maybe some popcorn. And we're done by 5 or 6 o'clock. We don't normally stay for fireworks anymore unless it's a rare occasion that we have people in town. But for the most part, our son is toast by 6-7 o'clock. And we are too. So we head home. We hop the monorail back and grab our car at the resort, and it's about a 30-minute drive home for us. So we usually don't stay very late. So it's unique for us to see the park at night. We get pretty geeked out when we're there late enough to see the lights on Main Street, because it just doesn't happen very often with the little one. But that's our approach. So we kind of lean towards what the crowds are doing, and if the crowds are bad, then we just utilize our fast passes and do character experiences and hang out on Main Street. And if there aren't too many lines, like, we'll get on Pirates, we'll get on as many rides as we can, but otherwise we're just gonna be there, enjoy it, take it all in, and then head home and go to sleep in our own beds.
Nice. Well, that's one advantage to being a local, because you can, like you said, you can roll in there after doing your breakfast and hit your fast passes, and if the place is you can be like, all right, I can come back next weekend, which is fantastic. And I'm sure many people, that makes them jealous or aggravated, because they go once every 2 years and they want to jam everything into 5 days, which is literally impossible. But that's definitely a good approach to it, especially about the dining reservations that you said, because yeah, that plaza, that's I think one of my favorite restaurants in all the park. I love that restaurant. I think the sandwiches there are fantastic, and the ambiance is great. It's small, and like you said, you can, you know, when my wife is and I have been there, just the two of us, we've walked up and just, you know, waited a half hour for a table, but we definitely...
And it's a great view, too. Like, if you sit down during the castle show, you can watch the whole thing and see the fireworks.
Yeah.
It's just really incredible spot that a lot of people don't know about.
Yep. Oh, definitely. I totally agree with that. I like the local view of it. That's definitely a completely different way of looking at the parks, because... Like you said, you're not trying to run around and hit everything, because you really don't need to. It's just not necessary. And
Our sense of urgency is completely different. And if it rains, like, we're out of there. Like, we're not putting ponchos on and doing the whole thing. Like, we're like, all right, well, that's our day.
Yeah. No, I mean, hey, it's a whole different way to look at it, because you're not bound to just being there a set amount of days as, like, a vacation. You know what I mean? It's just kind of like your local, you know, going to your local city park or something to hang out for the day. So it's definitely a whole different mentality, which is pretty cool. All right, let's see. Mr. Milford, what's your day plan?
Well, you know, since the kids are grown and gone, and it's usually just Sean and I on vacation, and we really want to just relax, you know, we aren't early people, so we don't get to the park at park opening. We usually get there 9:30, 10 o'clock. Sometimes I'll go by myself and Sean will come later. But I pretty much just kind of wing it. I mean, it's for me, it's not, I've been to most of the rides, so it's, I go hit, you know, the things I need to, like, or I want to, like, I'll probably mosey back to the Haunted Mansion, and then work my way back through Liberty Square, back to Frontierland, and do Big Thunder Mountain, which the last two times I was there was not even open because it was in refurb, and then work my way back to Adventureland. That gets me to lunch, head back up to Main Street, grab a hot dog at Casey's if that's what I'm in the mood for. Sometime around that time, I'll go grab my Wizards of Magic... What is that game called? Wizards of Magic Kingdom.
Sorcerers of the Magic
Kingdom. Sorcerer of Magic Kingdom. I'll go grab my Sorcerer's cards for my trip that day. And every once in a while, I'll go play the game. Kind of mosey around the park. Later in the afternoon, if I went by myself and my wife shows up, usually it's a repeat. We go do Haunted Mansion again. And we'll work our way back across Fantasyland. She's a big Small World person, so we have to get the Small World ride in. We have to do Mickey's PhilharMagic. We don't do Dumbo. We, you know, we don't do the Dumbo ride. We don't do the carpets because, you know, we've ridden those things so many times. And then we've got to go do Buzz Lightyear because that's her favorite ride there. And usually, yes, she ends up beating me. That'll usually get us somewhere around 5, 6 o'clock. We'll go grab dinner. And really, we don't have a particular place in Magic Kingdom that we get dinner. We used to like to go to Pecos Bill's, but the food there has gotten to the point that it's just not that great. So we usually, sometimes we'll end up back at Casey's. Sometimes we'll end up at Cosmic Rays because it's still decent, though I hear they just changed their menus again here not so long ago. And then we just kind of roam around, watch the entertainment, catch a stage show if that's still going on. Back in the day, catch the Electric Light Parade, you know, Spectrum or Main Street Electrical, though now it's in California. And back in the day before that, Spectrum Magic, which is unfortunately no longer with us. And we'll hang around, watch the castle show for the video show, and then catch the fireworks.
Cool.
Mosey back to the resort. Sometimes Sean will stay late with me. Sometimes if it's a late park night, I'll stay till 2 o'clock and go do all that all over again.
Nice. Yeah, definitely puts a whole different spin on it when you don't have kids at all to worry about.
Yeah, when you're adults by yourself, you just kind of, we really just wing it. Now, one exemption to that is if we've got her mom with us, who's in her 80s, that changed the plans a little bit because we really mosey around the park at that point. Hmm. So, because she doesn't want to just go like I do. Of course, my wife doesn't want to go like I do either. But, you know, that changes things too. So,
definitely. Yeah, it's amazing how much it changes when you don't have to worry about little ones. You can definitely, like you said, you don't have to get there at rope drop if you're not worried about rushing to the major rides and, you know, dining. You can pick your choice. You don't have to worry about picky eaters or anything like that. You pretty much can wing it. I mean,
yeah.
If you wanted to do fast passes, you can kind of do them on the fly or that morning, you know, see what's available. But
though I am really curious, so hopefully when I go in September, I'm going to try and go one morning and catch rope drop and catch the new opening show because I have not seen that yet.
I can tell you, you're not missing anything. My aunt and
my—that's what I hear. But
my aunt and my uncle are there this week, just the two of them. And he periscoped it Sunday morning. They got there Saturday night, so I think he periscoped it Sunday morning or Monday morning. It must have been Sunday because I was home, and I watched it. And it's a shell of what it used to be. You know, the characters come out, and there's the Royal Proclamation guy. It's not even like the mayor or any of that stuff. There's no song. The characters kind of wave and they sing, and it's just kind of blah. It's kind of a shame.
Yeah.
I mean, I get why they moved it, but maybe throw a little more effort into it. So, you know.
Well, there's no mayor, right? Because they got rid of all those people.
Didn't
they get rid of the people that were playing the mayor and the Main Street citizens?
I don't think so. I think in the studios, a lot of them got let go, but some have come back. I don't think so. I think they still have. I think the mayor's still there, and I know he was still there when Melanie went.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think they're still there.
I think they're all. I don't think they would get rid of them. That's a mainstay. Okay. I mean, people look forward to them. And what's the woman's name? Hildegrand.
Oh, yeah.
And then you've got the fireman. And, yeah, no, those characters are great. So I hope they didn't get rid of them. You need that. You need that streetmosphere still.
Yeah, I miss the little band that used to play in Frontierland. You know, the guy with the tuba.
Yes, the Banjo Brothers.
And, yeah.
Or I forget what they were called. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, those guys aren't there anymore, that's for sure.
Yeah.
They used to do a little show, like a Woody's Roundup show, too, with Jesse.
And yep.
They did, like, a little parade thing, like, right in that area, right in front of Country Bears and stuff. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Well, yeah, Jesse and Woody and yep. Even the Country Bears would be out there in that.
Yep, absolutely.
It was back in the day.
It was like a little hoedown thing.
Yep.
Yep. Oh, well. Thanks, Avatar Land. Okay.
The giant sucking sound.
So... All right, so now we're going to go over to our West Coast Disneyland extraordinaire Jessica and see what she comes up with for a day in Magic Kingdom in Florida.
Yikes. Okay. So I'm not even going to pretend that I know the park well enough to know how long it will actually take me to get from place to place, but I have an idea of the order I want to do it because I have been there once. So I think what I would do is I would start my day in Fantasyland, only because in Disneyland, I always start either in Tomorrowland or Frontierland. So it would just be nice to try something new. And I was really obsessed with Fantasyland and Disney World. I thought it was just so pretty, and I was freaking out at all the different castles there are everywhere. So even if I couldn't get on any rides, I just want to hang out there. But I think for, assuming I could get whatever fast passes I wanted, I would want to have the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train for sure. And then I think I would also probably do the Haunted Mansion and then Thunder Mountain Railroad. Because the rest of the stuff, I don't really mind waiting so much, but like Space Mountain, I don't really mind waiting, and Splash Mountain, I don't really mind waiting. So I think I would pick those, but I would start the day, you know, doing the Little Mermaid and all the ones kind of up in the back. I didn't get on the Barnstormer when I was there, so I'd like to try it because Adrian's family seems really into it. So I feel like I'm missing out on something.
It's really cute.
It's a lot of fun.
It is fun. Yeah. And I do, you know, it's a small world, and I'd have to do Mickey's PhilharMagic at least twice because I was obsessed with it. I thought it was so cool, and Disneyland needs it because it's really awesome. And then I think, you know, assuming I could get through all that stuff before lunch, which might not be possible in the world, but I would head over into Liberty Square, and I'd like to try to eat at the Liberty Tree Tavern.
Yes, you would.
It was closed when I went there, but it looked so cool. And I've heard it's really good. Is that right? Is it good?
Yes, it's fantastic.
Okay, yeah, so that would be my
ideal. It is really good food, yes.
That's my ideal lunch spot. And then I'd like to, you know, do the Hall of Presidents and the Haunted Mansion a couple of times. And I also really liked the Memento Mori shop because Disneyland does have a Haunted Mansion gift shop, but it's not obvious from the outside that it is. It just looks like a normal shop. So I really liked that building. And I thought it was really cool. So I would definitely have to go there. And I don't know, the riverboat, it's not the Mark Twain. What is it called in Disney World?
The Liberty Bell.
The Liberty Bell. I'd like to take a ride on that to see how Tom Sawyer Island is different and to kind of get a feel for the Rivers of America. Because I spend a lot of time in that area in Disneyland, so I think it would be fun to kind of get to know it better in Disney World. And then I think around parade time, I would go to Splash Mountain or Thunder Mountain and kind of try to hide from it in the corner because, to be honest, I don't really care that much about parades, and I would just like to avoid the congestion of everyone just standing there. And Thunder Mountain's kind of nicely tucked in the back there, so that's probably where I'd go.
And you'd be trapped there.
I know, but there's not really a good spot over there.
No, you know what? If the parade starts in Frontierland, so if you were in line for Thunder Mountain and there was any sort of reasonable amount of wait, by the time you got off, it would be gone and those ropes would be down and you'd be able to cross over into Adventureland or continue your way around. You can walk along the river there, and that's kind of where they send you anyway. Boardwalk type area.
Around the river?
It makes a right at Hall of Presidents where you would get on the Liberty Bell where the dock is. It hangs a right and goes over the bridge to the hub.
That's interesting. The one in Disneyland starts basically where the mine train is in the Magic Kingdom and then comes down Main Street that way.
Okay.
So that's interesting.
Yeah. It starts in Frontierland. They walk out right where kind of on the side of Splash Mountain is where the parade comes out from. And then it goes straight down past Country Bears and the Shooting Gallery and then into Liberty Square right past the Liberty Tree Tavern. And then it hooks a right around the Liberty Bell, pretty much goes over the bridge and then in around the hub and then down Main Street and ends by the barbershop and the old fire. Well, it's the firehouse now, it's just a shop, but that's the route it uses in the Magic Kingdom.
Well, if it was parade time, maybe I would just take the train to escape it then. I don't know.
Well, I mean, not many people collect on the Frontier everybody likes to watch it from Main Street, so that's where all the congestion is. So, I mean, there's people back there, but if you were going to plan on doing either one of those mountains, by the time you got done with either one of them, like I said, the ropes would be gone for that area, and you'd be okay.
Okay.
You may catch a little bit of the end craziness of people just getting where they're going to go, but...
Right, but that's better than, you know, still traffic.
Right, absolutely.
So in the later afternoon, I think I'd kind of snake through Adventureland. I really like the Tiki Room, even though it's really, you know, kitschy. I think I'd still go in there anyway. And obviously Pirates is like my favorite ride, so I'd have to go in there once or twice. And then I'd make my way down Main Street at sunset, ideally, because when the lights first start to come on Main Street, I just think it's so pretty. And it's just kind of a fun place to hang out, and it's kind of a... I don't know. I think it's the best when it's still light enough that you can see where you're going. Because I don't know about at the Magic Kingdom, but at Disneyland, when it gets dark, it's really hard to see. The lighting's not that great. So when it's still, the sun's still up and you can see, but all the lights on the buildings come on, I just think it looks really cool. And then for dinner, if I could get a reservation, I'd love to go to Be Our Guest. Because I went there for lunch and was immediately obsessed with it. So... That would be so cool if I could have a dinner reservation there. And then I think I would save Tomorrowland for nighttime when it's all lit up in neon and just really cool. I'm really, really into the People Mover, so I would have to go on that a couple times. And the Carousel of Progress. Those are probably my two favorites in Tomorrowland. I don't really care that much about the Speedway or the Stitch ride. I wasn't that into.
It's closed now anyway.
Oh, okay. There you go.
So,
but
stroller parking now.
I'd mostly be there, I think, for Space Mountain, the Carousel of Progress, and the People Mover. And then maybe I'd watch the fireworks from the People Mover or something. I don't know.
Do you have the Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor in Disneyland at all?
No, we have. There's a Monsters, Inc. dark ride in California Adventure, but we don't have the Laugh Floor.
I think the Laugh Floor is hilarious.
Yes,
it's another one of my favorite things. Just FYI.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think I went on that one. I went in January when I went, so and the weather was really bad and a lot of stuff was closed. So I'm trying to remember if it was closed or if I just didn't go on it. But I don't remember it. Is it a live show?
It's like an interactive show. You go into like a theater and it's kind of the same technology if you went to Turtle Talk with Crush. So it's animated characters on the screen, but there is live comedians behind there speaking as them. And the audience is completely part of the show through almost the whole show.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, it's great. It's definitely a great show. Especially if you go in there wearing anything kind of strange or off or have anything that sticks out.
Wear a Hawaiian shirt or a crazy hat, you'll end up being that guy.
You'll end up being any part of it. You can, you know, most of the time, they have different skits, but a lot of the times they kind of reenact. They do a real quick version of the movie synopsis. So they'll pick a little girl to be Boo, they'll pick somebody to be Randall, and they'll pick somebody to be Sully. And they'll go through like a real super duper like 45-second thing of the movie, and it's hysterical because you get people that play along and you get people that just want to have no business of it, but they don't leave you alone. If they pick you, like doesn't matter. So awesome. That's you definitely have to catch that next time you're out here.
Yeah, I'll put it on my list for sure.
All right, well hey, listen, I give you an A+ for that because that was good.
Was impressive.
Really?
Being here, oh, absolutely. For being over here only once, and I mean, you did it right.
I passed the test. Woo!
Absolutely. Listen, Tomorrowland at night, there's really nothing better to me. I mean, Main Street is beautiful, but that's my spot. Tomorrowland at night with the music, I can just sit there like under the People Mover and just watch the neon palm trees and taking that music and the ambience of that land is just, oh man, that does it for me. I don't have to do anything. Just
I
sit
like
there and just listen.
Fantasyland back there near the carousel. I think it's pretty back there at night too. On the back side of the castle, because I think many people don't go back that way.
No, not at that time, because we're all trying to scurry to the front.
Right.
So I do have a question. I don't usually like to have a big sit-down breakfast when I go to the park. I just like to grab a pastry or something. What's the best place to do that in the Magic Kingdom?
Well, you only have two places. You either have to stop at the bakery, which is now Starbucks, or back in Fantasyland, Gaston's Tavern has the famed cinnamon rolls that used to be at the original Main Street Bakery.
Yeah.
That's really about it.
But have I not convinced you to try the fruit Nutella waffle yet?
You did. I always forget about Sleepy Hollow. I really do.
Is that the place in Liberty Square?
Yeah, it's right over the bridge.
Yeah, I had a waffle there.
Right before Hall of Presidents.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
I had a waffle there. It was really good.
It's my favorite.
And they added donuts to Casey's Corner.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. I did read that. Yes, you're right. So they're definitely adding more stuff, yeah. It's not as sparse as...
The spicy chicken waffle at Sleepy Hollow is pretty awesome, too.
Did they bring that back? Because didn't it go away for a while?
Yeah, it's back.
I had it in October. Oh. It was awesome.
How could it not be? Cool. All right, well, I guess it's my turn. All right, so my day in the Magic Kingdom with my family. All right, so there's five of us in my family. We've got three kids, myself and my wife. So I'm going to take into consideration, I'm going to use my upcoming trip as kind of an example because I didn't know where to go from this. So we're staying at the Boardwalk. So that takes away a breakfast thing for me because they got the Boardwalk Bakery right there and they have those wonderful muffins in the shape of Mickey heads. So I will wander down there while everybody else is getting ready and grab those and we'll eat those on the way over to the park. Since we are driving...
I hate to interrupt, but we tried to stop there on Sunday or Saturday during the 10K. We ran into the bakery and we tried to get Mickey shaped muffins and we stood in line for like 15 minutes and they were already out. We were like devastated because we stopped mid race trying to get them and totally got shut down.
Yeah, no, I've learned. I head right down there at 6 o'clock when they open and I'll grab three or four of them. Yeah, no, because they sell out fast. They definitely do. They definitely do. I mean, they have other good stuff in that bakery, too. It's the sandwiches and the other things are great, but, I mean, everything's better Mickey-shaped. So that would be my breakfast thing, because my kids aren't huge breakfast eaters. They're hungry in the morning, but they're not complete monsters. So, and my son, being 12, he's an early riser, and he wants to get there and do roller coasters. So they kind of get up and at him fairly easy, just because... My parents were that way with me and my brother, so my wife and I have kind of bestowed that insanity upon our kids. There's no sleeping on a Disney vacation. So I think we'll stick to a plan my wife and I kind of did, because it fast passes I would make would be to keep everybody happy, because my kids range in age. I have a 12-year-old, a 10-year-old, and an almost 5-year-old. So in interest of keeping them all happy, and the older two wanted to do the roller coasters, and the little guy not being big enough to do all of them except Barnstormer, and he is tall enough to do the mine train, so we will definitely... I have a fast pass for that for our first day there, so he can check that out. But what I would probably do is, upon rope drop, since the welcome show is not anything that I need to see, I would probably just queue up to head back towards New Fantasyland and hit that first, wait in line, and probably... Do standby for the mine train, because at that point in the morning it's maybe going to be 20 minutes and I can deal with that, and so can the kids. And the queue is very cool. There is these interactive queues are phenomenal. They really do keep you entertained, and they do have a bunch of stuff to do in there to keep the kids occupied, for lack of a better word. So I think we would start with that, and then if anybody was still hungry after that, head over to Gaston's and grab something quick, or they have a fresh food cart, I believe, over there now, Prince Eric's something or other, it's called, in that over on the right side, across from the Ariel entrance, so we can grab some fruit or something else there if they're hungry. Probably hit Ariel while we're over there, and then maybe head back into Storybook Circus and... see what the wait for Dumbo is. I mean, like Crystal has said, I think that my kids love, even the older ones, running around and playing in that playground, so it gives you a little bit of a break while you're waiting for the ride, or even if you're not. And so definitely would try to hit Barnstormer and Dumbo while we were there. And then probably hop on the train and take a ride around, right around to Frontierland. And then by that time, I think I would usually have a fast pass for Thunder Mountain, so we'd hang around Frontierland at that point and see what else is there, see what the wait is for Splash. You know, the little guy, you know, maybe we'd probably break up. I would take the older two or my wife on a couple of the coasters and, you know, wait for one fast pass for the other, and the other one would maybe hit Country Bears or the Shooting Gallery with the little guy. We'll just kind of walk around, and or maybe the riverboat. I really enjoy the riverboat. It's a lot of fun. It's, you know, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, something like that, around there. So that's a lot of fun to just relax for a little while and just sit, or, you know, lean on the railing, however you want to do it. It's probably close to lunchtime at this point. And if we were in Frontierland, then I would either... If the cart that was the Golden Oak Outpost that was on the Frontierland and on the Adventureland side was still serving all those wonderful waffle fries with all the toppings, that would be my lunch, because they used to do the ones with that were BLT topping on it, and then there was another one that was pulled pork, and there I think there was a third choice too, but to my knowledge they're not doing that anymore, which is disappointing. So we probably just would hit Pecos Bill. My kids are pretty plain eaters, chicken nuggets, hot dogs, and maybe a burger, and they're happy. So I don't really search around too much for that, unless we had like a reservation for Liberty Tree Tavern or something along those lines. We haven't done the Crystal Palace in a bunch of years, just because none of us are real huge Pooh character fans. I mean, the food is great, but you know, my kids just never got into Winnie the Pooh. I was never a huge fan of Winnie the Pooh and those characters. I mean, so we tend not to make that our breakfast thing. And the castle, we haven't dined in years. I don't know that my kids have ever been in at Cinderella's Royal Table. So who knows? Maybe when they're older. I don't rush there, because I know I've heard the food has gone downhill immensely, and they're not huge princess people either, even my daughter. So it's of no... It's not something I need to do and spend that crazy money on, for sure. So
I think lunch and dinner are all, you're paying for the experience. But I'll tell you, breakfast, I have never had a bad experience at breakfast.
In the castle?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I didn't even know they offered breakfast. The only few times I remember eating there, it was always dinner with my parents when we were younger.
Yeah, that's our favorite pre-park opening breakfast. Okay. Is there. Just, again, an FYI.
Yeah, no, definitely. I didn't even realize that they did breakfast, so... Yeah, no, I definitely would look into it. I mean, I'm open to trying anything new. Like I said, it's probably been 15 years since I've been in that restaurant, so... So, lunchtime, we'd probably try to Pecos Bill, and then either wind our way through Adventureland, seeing as we're right there, and try to hit Pirates and Tiki Room. Then again, kind of like what Crystal's approach was, it kind of depends on lines at this point, because the other fast passes that I would have already preset would be Peter Pan, just because that one does get crazy, as we've talked about. And I've not seen that new interactive queue, but I enjoy the Mine Train coaster much more than Peter Pan, so I'd rather wait in that line at Rope Drop than go to Peter Pan for Rope Drop. So my kids have zero patience at this stage of the game, so unfortunately I can't make them wait an hour for Peter Pan, even though I would really like to see the interactive queue, because I've not seen it yet since it's been activated. Probably just see what we can do in Adventureland. Like I said, it would depend on the lines. Tiki Room is always pretty much a walk-in. I love that. It's one of my favorite ones, especially now that it's back to somewhat the full original show. You know, why they had to cut those few scenes out, I don't know. I mean, I do know, because the longer you're sitting, the less time you're buying stuff in the shops. So, but I would definitely try to hit that, and if not, Jungle Cruise. Sometimes depending on what everybody wants to do and how the crowds are going, I may shift fast passes around. That's the beauty of that system. You know, if you don't want to do one, or times are, it's not going how you planned, you can always pop on the app and, hey, let me switch this. Let me see if I can get this for later. Most things besides the major rides are not unavailable for the day, I would think. I don't know, Adrian, if you've experienced that or done that with the kids, if you've had to move stuff or shift stuff and found that.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, outside of like Mine Train and maybe like Soarin' or something in Epcot and Test Track, I don't think anything is like unavailable for the entire day
Yeah, the only thing in Magic Kingdom that I haven't been able to get is Seven Dwarfs. Pretty much everything else is fair game day of.
Right. And that even goes for like the meet and greets now, because those aren't even nutty anymore.
Yeah. Well, with Anna and Elsa gone.
Right.
Yeah.
Most definitely. So, I mean, trying to think of what timing would be at that point. Rolling through Adventureland, you're probably getting close to somewhat of a dinner time. I would like to think we would have I didn't forget about Be Our Guest, but I know that's not a... I and my wife enjoy it a lot, but I'm not, like I said, my kids aren't... They don't care about the fanciness of some of the meals. Like, at this stage, I like to go and try to have different stuff to eat besides the normal quick service things. And obviously, you get the experience of Be Our Guest, which I thought was fantastic. The one and only time we ate there for dinner, we ate in the West Wing, so that was awesome. I've eaten there for lunch a couple times and just kind of just landed in the main room. I've not eaten in the ballroom, but I've been in there. And just try to hit this, the biggies at that. With the little guy, I know he really likes Small World, which I do. I love that attraction. I don't, song doesn't bother me. It's just a great attraction, and probably more for how my kids have reacted to it as they've grown up and been going there. As toddlers, they just were fascinated by everything going on, the colors, the sounds, just watching them in that ride. So it's a memory thing for me, even though I enjoy it. But so having an almost 5-year-old who hasn't been in 2.5 years or so, I'm just very interested on his reaction to a lot of these things. The older two have been through it before, and they still enjoy it, but they're at that age now where they want to do the thrill ride things. And character meet and greets have never been high on their list, so we tend to kind of not wait in line for some of those, especially at the Magic Kingdom. Although over in Storybook Circus, they do have a bunch of them all kind of in one area there. Right, isn't it Daisy and Goofy and Minnie? And who else is over there? That's it, right? It's just those three, Adrian? I'm trying to remember. In the tent.
Yeah,
there.
I think so.
Okay. They should have Pete. It's called Pete Silly Sideshow.
I know.
I'd have him. I'd go take a picture with Pete.
I would totally take a picture with Pete. He's awesome.
Yeah, definitely. So in with that, we tend not to leave the park and go back to the room, but this trip, it may be something we entertain just because of the little guy, and maybe just to go take a break. My kids are huge on the pools, so I'm not listening to them say, can we go in the pool, can we go in the pool, can we go in the pool all day. We may take a break and skip the parade, which bums me out because I love it, but kids could care less about it. So, but we are traveling with my parents, so there may be a split there If they want to go back and rest, maybe some of the kids will go with them, and who knows. But for purposes of this, I guess, I'm going to say we probably would skip the parade and either hit a couple of attractions or just kind of sit and relax somewhere for a little while. Dinner, if we didn't have an ADR somewhere, would probably be in the Columbia Harbor House, just because I like the choices there. We got good stuff, different stuff. It's not just your normal burgers and chicken tenders and hot dogs and things of that nature. So I'd probably hang out there and do that. And then we'd definitely try to catch a Hall of Presidents show. And then make sure it's earlier in the day, which it's kind of hard to juggle because I know my oldest son really enjoys watching the Philharmonic, the Main Street Band, play. So I know early in the morning they're always down Main Street towards the entrance of the park, and then up closer towards the hub, I believe. But I know in the afternoons they're usually play right in front of like the Christmas shop by Hall of Presidents. So depending on how that worked out, maybe we try to catch them play their set there and then go into the Hall of Presidents and check that out. We try to go and see that. And then now they have that new Muppet show that's right there in that courtyard as well. So we would definitely try to catch that, just because I haven't seen it at all. And then as far as for nighttime, it would definitely be heading into Tomorrowland. And then if we used our three fast passes by then, I'd probably try to catch one for Space Mountain, at least for the older two and myself, or my wife, or whoever it worked out, But hanging out in Tomorrowland is really nice. I like it. People Mover is definitely has to get done multiple times. they like the Speedway, but I can usually talk them out of it for the same reasons that Adrian had said, because it's just bang, bang, bang. It's just back and forth, back and forth. And my daughter, who I usually end up riding with, thinks it is the most hysterical thing in the world. The last time we were there, I videoed the whole entire, on my phone, the whole entire ride, because she was just cackling like a lunatic the whole time and not paying attention to what was going on, and just bang, bang, bang. And because she was laughing and enjoying it, I was laughing, and it was just very funny. And it's, and I still keep that particular video on my phone, so if I'm ever having a bad day, I can just put that on and watch it, and it makes me laugh, because the cackle of a 6-year-old pretending to drive a car, it's just, I don't, you know, stuff you find funny of your own kids. But, and then let's see, as far as for nighttime stuff, you know, you have the projection show and the fireworks. As of now, there's no parade, and to my knowledge, when I'm there in 40 days, there's still not going to be a nighttime parade, so that kind of makes your options fairly easy. I enjoy the castle show and the fireworks. 2 out of my 3 kids do, so majority rules, and we end up staying, unless the little guy has completely fallen apart, but he's a night owl like myself and my daughter, so he's usually pretty good at that point. So, not being a local like Crystal, we try to not every night stay late, but, you know, the parks aren't open ridiculously late now because there is no, they don't have to do 3 nighttime entertainment things. They do the projection show and then the fireworks, and that's it. I don't think my kids have ever been there to see the kiss goodnight, so I know that's not high on their list. I mean, they've seen videos of it, of my parents when they're there, but so that, you know, that about rounds it out. And you know, it's as much as you try to plan for it, you kind of see where the day takes you. I mean, there's always snacks in between, Mickey bars and popcorn and everything of that nature. But that's basically it. You know, I mean, hit the major fast passes, try to keep everybody happy, and after you burn your first 3, try to get one for some of the Tomorrowland attractions. And yeah, I mean, that's about it. You know, there's things that we have to do, that my wife and I have to do, that we make the kids do, because it's, you know, Carousel of Progress being one of them, Hall of Presidents usually as well, although it's not even going to be open when we're there because it's closed, I think, until July. I believe it's not reopening too, so don't have to deal with that one this time. That's it in a nutshell. And being that we are driving down, we'll have a car on property, so we usually drive to the Magic Kingdom, so at the end of the night it's a little easier. You know, just take the monorail or the ferry boat back over to the transfer station, the ticket center, and head on back to our resort. Cool. And that's it. I probably mentioned 18 things that I would try to get done in the day, and maybe half of that would actually get done. I guess I was being very optimistic in it.
We're talking about, like, in the perfect world, this is what
yeah,
we would
no
do.
Doubt.
Right, you get whatever no fast passes you want, yeah. You get whatever yeah. reservations you want.
Yeah, like Adrian said, she had her strategy, and she kind of goes around the park in a clockwise manner. And that's usually what we try to do, but I'm telling you, we end up zigzagging back and forth, and it's just ridiculous. And it's just like, I roll my eyes every time, because like I said, I let the kids, you know, kind of let the kids, and I've explained to them before, I'm like, all right, guys, it's a circle. It's, you know, you've been here enough times, you kind of know what's where, so let's not be so, you know, we're leaving Pirates, and you're like, okay, I want to go on Buzz now. And it's, no. Buzz will be there when we get over there later, you know, so it's trying to train them to think of it in a way of what's going to be most beneficial to their time. You know, I mean, we're there a week, but still, you know, a week between 4 parks, it's, you know, you can't do it, you know. I can't run around the parks either with my parents in tow either. They can't walk as fast as they used to, so it has to be a nice leisurely pace, which is fine with me too. I don't enjoy running through the parks anymore either. I mean, if I get on the stuff, I get on the stuff. If I don't, I don't. I kind of Crystal's approach. I think I'm going to try to implement that with the just, you know, kind of taking it all in and just kind of realizing where you are, what is around you, and just, it's more than just physical attractions and doing something. Just take a minute and sniff the air, look at the buildings, look here, look there, just kind of explore, for lack of a better word, and seeing them see things for the first time that they've maybe never seen before, or pointing stuff out to them that I know of. That's, you know, hey, look, this is over here, or this is an homage to an older attraction, or something along those lines. Just seeing them, because they are starting to get into some of the things that, because they hear me talking about older stuff that's not there anymore, and how the parks was, and how we were, and my mother talking about what was there when my brother and I were kids, and things of that nature. So I think my son especially gets very inquisitive about things like that. So pointing that out to him is going to be really cool, because then I get to be like a teacher, but it's like actually stuff I'm interested in instead of having to help them with homework that I don't know how to do now. So teaching about Disney is definitely a lot more fun, especially when you're there. So that's all I got. I don't know if anybody has anything else they need to add or would like to add.
I thought that was interesting how different we all approach things.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I mean, the ages play a big role, is mm-hmm. what it comes down to. For those of us traveling with kids, it definitely takes a whole different turn on it, you know. Kind of like what Milford said, when him and his wife are just there now, I think that's kind of the approach that my wife and I took when we went in September. I mean, we made some fast passes, but there was days where I only made one or two, and we just kind of saw how the day went and what it was going to be. So I still try to, even with the fast passes, make my kids understand that there is sometimes where you're just going to have to wait in line, and as much as they grumble, they'll do it if they really want to ride the attraction. Otherwise, you know, I kind of took like the Crystal approach. I'm like, all right, then, you know, we'll head out then. I mean, if you don't want to wait, then that's fine, you know. So kind of trying to teach them the best of both of those worlds, because you can do a majority of it between fast passes and standby if you kind of do it smart. So trying to make them realize that is, you know, maybe a bigger task than necessary, but at least I can say I try. Okay, so we hope you all enjoyed that. I'm sure many of you out there have similar touring plans to how we do it, or maybe some of you have completely different ones. So we'd love to hear from you. Give us a shout on Twitter or Facebook, or shoot us an email, and we definitely would like to compare, see how everybody else would kind of do it, either people who don't visit as often as any one of us, or if there's any other locals that listen to the show that do it completely opposite from what Crystal had mentioned. You know, there's kind of no right way and wrong way. It depends on your family and what you enjoy the most and what you're looking to gain out of the day. So as I said in the beginning, this is going to be the first in a series of these kind of how you would tour the parks, you know, like a detailed version of this. We will definitely be covering all 6 U.S. parks, because none of us have been overseas yet. So if that ever happens, then we'll definitely throw those into the mix. Or we can do a speculation, too. Maybe that would be fun, too. You know, kind of look at a map and restaurants and be like, hey, if we did go here, this is what we would do. Which I know that's kind of right up Adrian's alley, the planning aspect of it. With that said, we're going to wrap this episode up, and we thank you all for listening. You can find everything you need to know about us and the Diz Explorers over on thedizexplorers.com. Please head over there and check out our website, where you can find links to all our other social media accounts on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. And also you can find links and contact information for all the individual troopers and where we all are on social media. Definitely download us and give us a listen. Subscribe on iTunes, Stitcher, TuneIn, and also on YouTube, if that's what you choose. Thank you to all those who have been with us from the beginning. Welcome to any new listeners. Thank you to those who interact with us on Twitter and Facebook. We really enjoy it. We love it. Have a great week, everybody, and we'll talk to everybody later.